Hi there guys, this is Michael Vincent. I want to take this opportunity to welcome you to a new initiative that I'll be producing on my YouTube channel. Over the next few days, I'll be sharing with you some short video clips, which I will call the Vincent Academy Magic Moments. I'll be taking the opportunity to share with you some personal insights regarding magic, performance, education, and the things that we can do to improve our magic step by step and improve exponentially as we go along in the craft. Today I'd like to talk about education. This is a critical conversation here because I was reading one of the quotes yesterday from the video that I posted, and somebody was asking a question about how do we maintain our standard, keep our levels high. Somebody even mentioned, what's the laugh about my PhD? Well, I'm going to address all those questions in this very short clip. First of all, the PhD that I got came as a result of my appearance at the 4F convention. It's a doctorate certificate that you get after a third performance at the 4F convention. Now, just consider this. The first time you perform at 4F, you do so simply because you have two key sponsors who have endorsed your appearance. After a successful performance, you will receive your bachelor's degree. If you should return and perform again, you will receive a master's degree. And as I just did in April, I gave my third performance after a third year gap, and I was honored with a doctorate PhD degree. Now, consider for a moment. The 4F organization is the only close-up convention in the world where you can attend by invitation only. This means you have to be invited. Not only that, you will be endorsed by two people who are already part of that initiative. So the people who recommended have endorsed your appearance. They will do so simply because they believe in you as a magician. I was quite lucky. Back in 2003, I had won the Magic Circle close-up competition, and as part of my prize, it was an immediate introduction to the 4F community. So that was my first appearance. I returned the following year, and I did my third appearance only a few months ago. So it was a wonderful distinction. Now, I put my PhD into the same context as someone who has gone to Harvard, Stanford, Oxford, Cambridge University. Think of an individual who has studied a specific subject and they wanted to get a degree in this particular area of interest. Why should it be any different for a magician? We've chosen magic. Not only that, I can only speak for myself. I really went down the rabbit's tube. I studied the subject. I became interested in psychology. I became interested in many other allied arts directly applicable to magic as a craft. Acting, dancing. Would you believe I studied ballet? Tap dancing. My mentor, Alan Allen, encouraged me to take dance classes. Not to become a great dancer, no. To become aware of my body, my physiology, so that when I walk out on stage, I can carry myself with real power and projection like a great dancer. Interesting. Voice classes so that I could learn to speak in a lower register so that my voice will carry in a very large room. Because the voice I have now is not the voice I started with. No, this is a voice that's been trained to speak in a very specific way. I'm just also getting present to another key factor that Alan inspired me with, my mentor, Alan Allen. He always said to me, Michael, read the newspapers. I said, why? He said, you need to know what's going on in the world because the people who will be hiring you, they will have far more important things on their mind than your card tricks. And it's important that you can navigate those conversations effortlessly. What kind of conversations, Alan? Current affairs, world affairs, to a certain degree, politics. To a limited degree, perhaps religion, who knows? You've just got to be able to have an opinion about many different subjects and be able to share your point of view with confidence, a certain level of surety. Only now can I truly see the beauty and the wisdom that he passed on to me. So I think if you're a member of my community, I want to pass this on to you. Don't just think that the world begins and ends with a magic trick. Consider the craft of magic, a raindrop in the reservoir of life, in the ocean of life. There's so much more to learn. Sure, we've got to master our craft, master the conversation, the delivery, the performance. We also have to learn how to navigate life and people in such a manner that people will find us interesting and acceptable. I hope this conversation gives you something to think about. Read interesting books other than magic. Stay tuned for the next conversation. Thank you for listening.